Welcome to Positive Atheism English channel. Today I am going to present you the book on Thoughts of Periyar compiled by Dr. K. Veeramani. Thoughts of Periyar 1. Brahmins have burdened us with the imaginary thing called Hinduism in the name of promoting our spiritual life and salvation. The word Hindu has no suitable meaning with reference to religion. In Arabic and Persian languages, Hindu means thief. Some people say that it first denoted those who lived on the banks of the river Sindhu, and the word Sindhu changed into Hindu. In course of time, it came to assume the name of a religion. Be that as it may, let us consider what at least Hindu religion is. Christian religion is based on the commandments of Jesus Christ, Mohammedanian religion on the message of Muhammad Nabi, and Buddhist religion on the teachings of Bhagavan Buddha. In the same way, every religion has a founder. There are facts regarding the commandment of the originator of a religion and the time of its origin. But do we have any authoritative source that tell about the founder of Hindu religion, about its doctrine, or about the time of its origin? They deceive people by telling Vedas are eternal. They were spoken by God. But is this a proper explanation? If they are really eternal and revealed by God, should they not be accepted as their scriptures by the people in all the continents and countries created by God? Why is it that more than 85% of God's people in the world have no faith whatsoever in these Vedas and have their own different scriptures? And worse still, even among the so-called Hindus, all are not permitted to have a knowledge of Vedas. It is ordained in the case of a vast majority among them that their tongues will be cut off if they recite the Vedas, their eyes will be pierced if they read the Vedas, and molten lead will be poured into their ears if they listen to the Vedas recited. Why is it cruelly ordained? Sundays and Fridays are holy days for Christians and Muslims respectively. Why is it that in the case of so-called Hindus, different sections of them observe different days in the week as special ones, and some people among them find even all these 7 days inadequate for observing special religious rites? Regarding religious symbols or signs, one person has namam, another one applies ash, another one has a black spot on, and yet another one draws a line with the paste made of sandalwood. If a person has vertical lines, another has horizontal ones. How did these differences arise? Why does everyone give a different explanation for these variations? Why should these various modes be imputed to gods? When we ask what a namam stands for, they answer that it symbolizes God's feet. If the two white vertical lines represent 2 feet, what does the red line in the middle signify? Even if they are accepted as representing God's feet, why do they draw them on the forehead of the image of God himself? There are 2 kinds of nama, one with a step at the base called Dhyankalai, and another without a step known as Vadakala. Why do they quarrel bitterly over these 2 kinds of namams? What is the reason for a section of people among the Hindus to speak in derogatory terms about all sorts of namams? In the same way, why are there different interpretations to the application of sacred ash, putting a dot or any other mark? Why is it that the names of our gods are not in our Tamil language but only in the Alain Aryan language? Why should there be a middleman between us and the gods when we perform the puja? Why should the mantras and prayers be in an Alain language? Nobody can deny that billions of rupees are spent for celebrating festivals and ceremonies and for performing rites and rituals in the name of Hindu gods. Huge amounts are spent in this way to confirm and to remind us daily that we live without self-respect. When the Madras legislature sought to pass a bill to regulate Hindu religion endowments by arting these huge expenditures, they raised a hue and cry saying religion was in danger. In the name of God and religion, festivals and ceremonies, rites and rituals, they have not only burdened us heavily with wasteful expenditure, but also undermined our self-respect, which is our birthright. By accepting the so-called Hinduism as our religion, we as Sudras assume a low status by birth, become slaves of the people of higher Varnas, and accept by implication the indignity of being called the sons of the concubines of Brahmins. And above all, we are made to believe that God has created us to occupy such a degraded condition. We have to prostrate before those who think we are dishonorable. Thank you.
Please download Samaram Multichannel app and watch your favorite channels from your mobile. App available on Google Play Store and subscribe to the channels.
For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.